Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Very nice to see you. Hello. Hello. Nice to see you all. Thank you so much for coming out. I am so glad you guys are here. It would be really weird if you weren't. But I'm so thrilled that you guys are here. I had a friend come see me at a show, that someone I hadn't seen in a long time, and he is really, really Christian. And he told me that he missed Bible study so that he could come see my show. Which is a really nice gesture, right? But then I'm like, oh no, now I have to be better than the Lord. Like, I'm funny, but not God funny. So I'm glad you guys are here. I am. I've been traveling a lot, and I've gotten to go to some really nice places, and I've gotten to go to some really not nice places. So can we just take a collective sigh of relief, just that we're not in Albuquerque, New Mexico? Can we just enjoy that? Just really take that in for a minute. That's a rough city. If you haven't been to Albuquerque, everyone looks like they just fought somebody. It's astonishing the number of bruises per face everybody got. Did you know Breaking Bad was a documentary? I had no idea. They just collected that footage and made a show. I think some places are just too hot to think. I think that's what it is. Like, we're by water, you know? Cooler heads can prevail. But some places you can tell people's brains are cooked. I was in Tucson, Arizona recently, and I saw a business called I Didn't Do It Bail Bonds. What? Not one brain cell. Just like, man, what are we going to call this? I don't know. What are all our clients going to say the minute they meet us? I didn't do it. All right, print up the letterhead. We're done for the day. I'm going to take a nap. It's 107. Why do we live here? I went to Carson City, Nevada. I'm going to amend that. I ended up in Carson City, Nevada. And the senior citizen home I saw was right across the street from the cemetery. How lazy that city planner was. Just be like, I'm not going to even let these people rent a car when they die. When these people die, they're just going to play cornhole with Gladys. Let me see if I can make it across the median. Ah, shit, I hit the rim. That was awkward. Let's push her across. Let's keep tailgating. Let's... I went to Vegas recently, and I what I love about Vegas is there's always something different happening at my hotel where I'm staying than what I'm doing. Last time I was there, there was a big drag convention, and we're starting to get used to what drag is, starting to becoming more of a mainstream thing, and some of us, like me, are learning in real time. I was in the elevator at my hotel, and it was me, a drag queen, full getup, and a family with kids. And I think we can all agree that the elevator is not enough time to explain what drag is to a child. Because the kids have legit questions. No judgments, just questions. And I don't want to explain this to them because they're not my kids. But the parents are sweating bullets. So I feel like I gotta step in. It's like, all right, we have a few floors. All right, so there's some men, there's like a woman inside them that they want to express, and so they put on a wig and makeup and a dress, and the kids are like, all right, calm down. So after they're done, they look like a lady, but they're still a guy. And I was like, yeah, you're getting it. Where does their penis go? All right, no more questions for the nice man. There were no more questions.